Weaves, where we're going to see some awesome entrances and different crosses. 14 into the tunnel under the dog walk as 15. Jump, jump, dog walk, and three jumps, including a wall as number 20. This is going to be a lot of fun, exciting. And I actually spoke to Andreas when we saw the white dog. And he said, you don't get a world championships gold. You are going to earn it.
And that's very true on this course, I think. We will see many different kind of handling techniques, I think, and different choices. And here we see Andreas in the image, our judge for today, for this class.
He looks focused.
And now we're going to watch Annika of Klerkel and Storma, who was the white dog for this class.
And look at this run into that tunnel, around the jump and up on the A-frame. All the way down, around again, and then the long jump. Up on the seesaw. And the tunnel, and look at this weave entrance. Look at that, how amazing. And she catches up Storma over that jump, into the tunnel, inside. And that's actually easier than it looks because the obstacle is better. A running contact and all around, over the wall and to the finish. And maybe we will see
it's 1:40 left of this last course walk here. We can see Joni Orenius, among others, from Sweden, walking. And here you can see the high five between Annika and Andreas after a well-completed course. It's a beautiful dog, Valhunden Storma, and Annika of Klerker is a really good handler.
We have, as yesterday, 145 teams in large. And hopefully we will see everyone on the starting line and running the course.
Yes, and we have of the 145 who will start this course, we have 96 who has results from yesterday, who is also competing for the World Championships. We're going to start with the ones who were disqualified yesterday, which means they don't have the chance of taking the World Championship, but they can of course win today's race. And of the 96 handlers who got through the course, we have 62 with zero faults. So I think you will have to do a really quick, clean run to take home this World Championship.
Yes, I think so too.
But we will have to see.
I think any minute now, the last course walk will be over. And as we can see, there's so many techniques in the weave entrances. There's some behind crosses, some blind crosses, and some front crosses even.
Yes, there are.
Last course walk is over, and our staff is taking out all of the competitors.
So we are almost ready to go.
We are almost ready. Andrea Silverberg, the judge.
And we also have a guest over by the wall. His name is Tommy Hagström.
And we also have Tommy Hagström as a contact judge on the ups at the dog walk.
Okay, so then.
And let's start from the beginning with number one. Alexandre Borges from Brazil with the Border Collie Eva.
And as said, these first handlers was disqualified from yesterday, but they can still compete of the class today, of course.
Yeah, and we have a good chance to watch the course. Oh!
That's the obstacle from the wrong way. Nice entrance to the tunnel. And look at that weave entrance. Oh, and the dog saves it. Nicely done. Around 14, into 15, and up over 16, 17, and then the dog walk. And over the wall, and up the last one.
Next up, we have number two, Isabel Guedes from Portugal with the Border Collie Kira. Oh, she does something special.
Yeah, but it worked.
Five faults on the contact at the A-frame.
Oh, wow. What a nice weave entrance. And through the tunnel there. The dog walk is, oh, not a hit. And they're in 10 faults. 41, 43.
Look at this start. She walks around the course in the start. We have number three now. Greg Derrett from Great Britain with the Border Collie Addict.
Yes, and Greg Derrett has been doing agility since 1990, and he took team gold in 2015. Through the tunnel nicely. Let's see the weave entrance. Oh, look at that. Really nice. A wrap around 14 through 15. Inside 16 there. The dog walk. The dogs are landing pretty close to the long jump. A jump there and a back cross. And he's through. 0 faults, 40-21. So leader in the class so far.
And we have number four, Hiroshige Yamasaki from Japan with the Border Collie Lazy.
Yes, and Lazy, she had 6 puppies last year, he has told us. Up the A-frame, it's a hit, round 5, 6, out on 7.
Oh, that was almost stepped close on the long jump there. Oh, nice seesaw. And a really nice weave entrance.
Good wrap over there through 15, inside of 16, 17. And really tight around 17. Nice hit. The wall, and yes, it's 0 and 38, 54 up in the lead.
Next up, we have number five, Pau Serrano from Siracusa from Spain with the Border Collie Super.
Yes, and Super is a Swedish bred dog from Åsa Emanuelsson's dog. Super can be really, really fast, we know.
Uh-oh,
that
long
was
turn.
A long turn. Up over 9. That's a nice seesaw. a little bit after in the split time if he wants to win this class. But with a really tight couple of fences here.
Oh,
that's
nice.
So far ahead of that dog. And it's
a hit.
It was a hit. Oh, it's a bar down. Five faults and 39-46.
And we have number 6, Daisy Peel from USA with Frodo.
And she takes that side of the A-frame, around there, 6 and 7, and that's a tight turn after 7. Good dog who will be able to stop that far fast. That's a refusal. The dog didn't really get what she meant. She's a bit after in the split time, and that's sadly an elimination. Wrong tunnel. They're cheering for her. I think the United States won the bronze in medium earlier this day, so they still have something to celebrate.
We already, after 6 dog, have 3 that dropped the bar after the dog walk.
Yes.
So this is going to be really interesting to see. And we have number 7, Renee Prinsloo from South Africa with the Border Collie Savvy.
Round number 3, that's a misunderstanding and refusal. It's a hit on the A-frame. Round 5, 6, 7.
Oh, nice turn.
Really nice turns there over 7, 8, 9. And a good seesaw.
Five faults in the weaves.
Yes.
10 faults total.
So far. 15, the inside of 16, yes. Round 17 nicely. Up the dog walk, and it's a hit. Round 17, up, and 10 46, 21.
Number 8, Anita Sliagi from Hungary with the Border Collie Dita.
And Dita was placed 2nd in the World Championship last year individual.
Oh,
it's a drop bar. Around on that one. 6 and...
You can hear this dog scream when it's running. 10 faults for 2 drop bars.
And it tried so hard to be tight after the long jump, so it got a bar down instead. It's pretty good time, if you see to the split time, but still 10 faults. And up the dog walk. Yes,
nice dog walk.
Good dog. And there you go, 10 faults, 40-24.
And we have number 9 from Great Britain, Dan Shaw with the Border Collie Geek.
Nice hit on the A-frame. Really nice and tight over 5. Oh, look what tight he gets. It's almost like he hits the long jump, but he doesn't. And the seesaw is really good. It's a really good split time for this to be in the lead. He has the fastest split time so far.
Now he needs to run.
Dog walk. And it's a hit. And around there, he's over that, and they're in on 38-77. Second place so far. Current in the lead has 38-54.
And we have number 10, Gustavo Villavicencio from Peru with Border Collie Bono.
This nice is a big tight border collie. Did you see how he just like fell over number three?
Yeah. Five falls on the A-frame. Oh,
misses the long jump and takes the wrong jump.
Actually, we only have, out of 10 dogs now, 3 eliminations.
Yeah,
not that
good.
Much.
No, I would have thought many more on this kind of course.
3 clean runs so far.
Yesterday's course we talked about, and then we had the first half was like run fast, and then it was technique. Here it's all about technique all the way.
Yeah.
And of course you have to run fast as well, but it's technique, technique, technique.
Yeah. And number 11, José Manuel Davila Rosales from Venezuela with Tipay. I think he has the longest name in this start.
Over three nicely. It's a hit on the dog walk. Let's see where he can. Oh, that's a nice tight, but he gets a little long after the long jump. Yeah. He gets so fast. And it's
the dog needs to have a really good technique at the long jump and jump it.
Look at that weave.
Really tight and low to get the turn right.
And then he has to be able to really break after. Let's see this. Oh. It's not a hit. It's a five.
About jumping. Long jumping.
And no, he misses the last one. So a refusal as well. 10 faults, 44-62.
Number 12, Ricardo Tubaldini from Brazil with the Border Collie Flora.
Drop bar, really, really tight, and didn't really get over that bar.
Nice long jump.
And a five on the A-frame as well.
It's
five in the weaves. Didn't really get to break enough.
Almost in the tunnel.
But it was like he just was stuck in the hand or something. He just followed in exactly a circle. And it's a hit. And over 21. 15 faults, 44-43. But all of these days we haven't seen anyone have a five on the up on the dog walk.
No, actually not.
That's nice.
Number 13, Dan Fader from Luxembourg with the Border Collie Iskreen.
It's a hit on the A-frame. Nice around there.
In Sweden we actually doesn't judge the ups on the contacts anymore. Five faults on the long jump. 10 faults so far.
And a nice entrance. Did you look at that dog turn? God, that was nicely put.
Yeah, it turned on a penny.
Yeah, it really did. And over that one, let's see the dog walk. No, it's a five. I thought he would hit, but not. 10 faults, 40-61.
Number 14, Dalma Nagy from Hungary with the Border Collie Mabon.
This is their first time at the World Championships. And Mabon actually has two names. He also is named Kumini because they can't choose.
What a luxury problem with a dog. We can't choose any name, so we take two.
Very tight and nice from 7 to 8. And that's a good split time, a little bit off the current leader, but that you can fix if you get really tight and nice turns here. And it's a hit, round there, up, and 0 faults, 39-21.
It gives them a second place so far.
Yes.
And we have number 15, Leandre van der Merwe from South Africa with the Border Collie Savvy. another Savi.
Yeah.
And another from South Africa. Two team members from South Africa with the same name at on the dogs. Yes, and we have the front cross right there.
The funny part with the leader we have today, who ran at 38:42, is that the
dog... Oh, look at that running dog!
Yeah, oh, nice. Oh. Oh, no, a little stop before the jump. 5 volts, 41:64. The leader in this class, Hiroshige, his dog is called Lazy.
Doesn't look kind of lazy to me.
No.
Number 16, Natasha Wise from Great Britain with Pebbles, a border collie.
Natasha has been world championship, well, oh, a five with the drop bar. She has been world champion several times with her border collie Dizzy, who competes in medium. It's a good time. That's an elimination.
And we have a tunnel to match.
And Natasha is actually getting married in a few weeks. We got from her friends here. So congratulations. Hope you have a
I would
nice
like to congratulate her husband or wife, actually.
Yes, of course. I hope they just have a great day.
Yeah, the fourth eliminated dog so far. When we're going to watch number 17, Aina Bia Lundqvist from Norway with the border collie Enzo.
And the Norwegian crowd went wild here before they started. It's a drop bar on number four.
Three. And a lot of drop bars at number three, actually.
Yeah, number three and 19. The one before the wall. Through the tunnel nicely, and a refusal at the weaves.
Two refusals.
Yes. 15 faults in total so far. Through the tunnel there nicely. Let's see what she can do here with the line. Oh, look how beautiful and tight.
Oh, jumped off. And wrong way after the dog walk means disqualification. Our fifth so far.
And next up we have an interesting couple.
Yeah, we have number 18. It's Selko Gora from Croatia with the border collie Tama. And it isn't his, right?
No, Tama is not his dog. It's Tama's first world championship, and her owner has said that however it goes, whatever results they get, they want a lap of honor with Tama in here. And I can totally understand them. Up the seesaw, look what a nice seesaw, and it's a good time. It's a really good time, fastest so far. Split time of 16:53, leader had 16:62. Come on, Shelko. Nice over there, over that tight. Let's see, I'm guessing he has running.
Oh,
so yes,
what a
he
nice
has.
Running. And
run,
this
Shelko.
Is
39:13.
39:13 gives them a second place so far after Hiroshige and Lacey from Japan that's still in lead.
Nice run from Shelko.
And we have number 19. It's Prusola Shasapi from Greece with the border collie Muffin.
Oh, what a big jump. Got a bar down there.
Yeah, and I talked to her
and
before.
And five on the A-frame.
She's actually going to the Norwegian Open after this.
Oh, funny. It's always a good competition.
Uh-oh.
That's a misunderstanding and the wrong tunnel. Elimination.
We have 19 dogs competed so far. We have only 6 eliminated dogs out of 19. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 clean runs.
Yes.
And we thought this course would be a lot harder.
maybe it is as hard as we thought. They are just really, really good.
And we have from Denmark, right up, number 20, Morten Juul Hansen with the Border Collie Spotty.
And Denmark got an individual gold in small earlier today. So the crowd is really
sharing, and yes, they're hoping for the best.
Let's see what he can do over. Oh, that's a nice turnover 7. 9. And the seesaw.
Oh!
He's a bit after the split time.
Yeah, and the dog, like, jumped with all four paws at the same time.
Yeah. And
all the way down.
Around there. The wall, and yes, 42-11. 0 goal. It's a really good thing that the long jump is so soft, because then the dog can really turn tight without risking an injury.
We have number 21. It's Elpida Ismail with the Border Collie Diesel from Greece.
Oh, that was a nice jump over number 3. Just lifted up his back paws.
Uh-oh.
That's the short
way. A refusal. It jumped between the poles.
Yes.
And then you have to take it again to get it right.
And nice weave entrance. Look at that dog do the weaves. Nice and tight. Round in 15. Up there. Up again. And the dog walk. Yes.
Oh.
God, what a nice dog walk. And they're through. 5 volts, 42-14.
And we have from Portugal, Sergio Sousa with the Border Collie Cat. And we're going to see him soon again with his other dog, because he's running with two dogs.
And up the A-frame nicely. Round 5, 6.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
She got over. That's almost amazing.
She was like paddling. Uh-oh, 5 on the seesaw. She was like paddling over the long jump.
Yeah, but
to
she
get
missed
over
it. And that's the important thing.
I think this is kind of a small border collie, actually.
Yeah.
Oh, that's 5 falls on the dog walk.
38, 35, 10 falls.
But it was a really, really nice time.
Yes, it was.
Number 23, Tracy Lander from South Africa with the Border Collie Esprit.
Oh, misses number 3, gets a refusal there. It's a nice hit, nice and low on the A-frame. Over the 7, really nice. Look what a tight turn she gets.
Oh,
that's a
nice and easy.
She got a little bit of a late split time, but that was because she missed number 2, of course. I think this is a pretty fast dog, otherwise. Nice dog walk, and she's over. 5 volts, and 41-81. Would have been nice to see her time without that stop.
So. Yeah, we have next up, number 24, Svetlana Kreslina from Latvia with the Border Collie Salsa.
This is a really excited dog, as you can hear. And up, and over 9. Let's get the seesaw done, yes. It's a really good split time. She has a split time of 16:28, and the leader had 16:62. Come on. And over there, yes, up the dog walk. Take it. Oh, that's a nice dog walk.
Look at this time!
Yes, 37.52.
Right up in the lead with a whole second, second faster.
That's a great time.
Svetlana and Salsa. Number 25, Katerina Akimova, also from Latvia, and with border collie Shori.
Almost 2 seconds after in the split time. That was. They fell a bit.
She was choosing to give her dog some love instead of just taking the weaves again, because they did bump in together, and that's so much more worth. She's disqualified for that, but it's much worse to have a great and happy dog then do the weaves correctly.
Look what a nice dog walk. That's the totally right decision to make.
Yeah.
Good one.
Those kind of handlers are really my favorites.
Yes. Good one, Ekaterina. And we're going to take in Denmark, which you can hear from the crowd.
Yes, number 26, Ellen Agger, and the border collie Wave.
He was really excited in the start. Gets over three nicely. And it's a hit on the A-frame. Nice around 8-9. Let's see the time. It's a good time. It's 16:41. The leader had 16:28. Look at that weave. Through the tunnel. Inside 16, round 17, and now you have to run.
This is a big dog, and it takes a lot of running.
What a good stop. And 39.98, zero faults.
A fifth place so far.
Yeah. And the crowd is really cheering. They thought it was a really nice run.
Yeah, and we have number 27 from Greece, Nikiforos Orfanakos. With the Belgian Shepherd Duda.
Yes. Either Duda is really light for being a Belgian Shepherd, or she's starting to get old. I think she's light over the face. Really nice seesaw. That's a nice save.
And a calm dog can do that with the head on the right place.
Yeah. She knew what she was doing. And let's see this dog walk. It's a 5. And over there, 5 faults, 46.30.
And we can see those weaves. Number 28, Anja Primosic from Slovenia with the border collie Annie. And a tunnel. First one, right?
Yep. Haven't seen that one before. This is a very excited dog. Look at that run.
We have 28 dogs so far. And we have 8 eliminated dogs. Just 8 out of 28.
Yeah. Look at this dog running. He just lower himself and just pushes everything he has into running. It's so cool to see those kind of dogs. Can't be easy to be a handler when it's in this speed. Look at that dog walk.
And we have number 29, Juliana Blanco from Colombia with the border collie Trek.
This is kind of a big border collie. Let's see how he solves this technical course. If I remember correctly, he was kind of tight. This is a very tight, large border collie.
Yeah, he touched the wing there, but the bar didn't drop on number 3.
Look at that tight turn. Mostly of these large border collies has problem with the really tight turns, but not this one. It's a really beautiful dog. Look at that weave entrance. Through the tunnel. Oh, that's a drop bar. Nice over the dog walk. And there too, 5 points, 43-12.
And we have from Poland up next, number 30, Aleksandra Klobokowska with Border Collie Yuka.
That's also an excited dog. Tell me what to do. Over seven nicely. Look at that way. Beautiful way. Oh, it trips a little bit.
Uh-oh.
That's a five on the seesaw. But a beautiful split time.
Wrong tunnel entrance under the A-frame means elimination. Oh, what a dog walk.
Yeah, that's nice. Really nice. Let's see this.
Number 31, Miroslav Tomic from Serbia with the Belgian Shepherd dog Condor.
And as you can see when he walks in, this is a dog that not only competes in agility, he has actually competed both here in Agility World Championship, but also in FCI IPO World Championship as the only dog ever to have done both.
And how amazing is that? A really all-round dog.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Oh, that's misunderstanding and the A-frame instead of the tunnel.
Yeah, like an IPO dog, he likes the A-frame.
Yeah.
And look at the hind legs.
Yes.
in the weaves. His back legs were amazing in the weaves.
Let's see here in the replay when he gets there. We have the A-frame.
And look at those hind legs. It's like he's stepping. Look at that.
It's
oh my
amazing.
God. And we have number 32, Noemi Schindler from Switzerland with the Border Collie Twice.
Nice around there.
Uh-oh.
And that's the tunnel. An elimination for Noemi and Twice.
We talked about that, Emma and I, in the medium final, and not think of what a dog shouldn't do. Think of what a dog should do.
Yes.
Like, think A-frame, A-frame, A-frame here, instead of don't take the tunnel, don't take the tunnel, because the dog is going to take the tunnel if you just thinks about it.
Yeah, if you do that, you often place yourself to, like, block or just make the dog to not take it, and then you're focused on the tunnel, and most of the time your body focuses on the tunnel and then the dog will.
Number 33, Siyue Xiaoye Su from China
with
the Border Collie Sunny.
I recognize that, what do you call it? That leash, I think it was sold here to this over this World Championship. And here we have it again, the tunnel instead of the A-frame. But look at that beautiful dog. She's so excited. Just tell me what to do, please, 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 I want to run.
And we have four elimination in a row.
Did you see that over the five? God, what a tight and nice dog. Yes, now it's the tunnel. Misunderstanding in the weaves. I think you meant this instead. I really love this kind of dog, where you really can see the love for the sport in their behavior. see the A-frame. Look, a beautiful stop.
And we have number 34, Raymond Rossi from Luxembourg with the Border Collie Easy. And we saw that tight turn from Sunny in the replay.
1-2, tight over 3. Oh, he almost hit the tunnel there, but he missed it. But a 5 on the A-frame. Long turn over there. And up on the seesaw. A 5 on the seesaw. And a split time of 17.69. The leader so far had 16.28. Around there, up the dog walk. It's a 5 on the dog walk. So 15 full and 40.82.
Next up, number 35 from Finland, Janita Leinonen with the Border Collie Fu.
And Janita and Fu were in the team that took bronze here on Friday. Nice over number 3. It's a hit on the A-frame.
And Fo was kind of sneaky in the start. Oh, she makes a front cross up there. That was really nice.
It was the first time.
Move.
It was close to that.
Oh.
Up on the... He missed the A-frame, but it's a refusal.
Yeah, and Janita saw that Fu was on the A-frame, and Andreas did not.
No.
So that's why she took it all over again, because I think she thought she was disqualified.
Yeah. Or at least she thought that with a 5, I will not win this anyway. So I can train a little bit on just this, so it will be correct.
And we have up next Norway, number 36, Lise Irén Hansen and the Border Collie Gosh.
And you can hear it's Norway because the crowd goes wild here. Oh, that was close. Nice hit.
Refusal in the weaves. Wrong side of number 16. And the first dog who took the long jump after the before the dog walk. Next up from Peru, number 37. Gustavo Villavicencio and the Border Collie Annika.
Nice, around 3. Oh, she got it wrong on the A-frame. You could see that already over the top, that she just got out of stride, and then she missed the A-frame there. That's a disqualification. They took the jump for the weeds.
It's when we're coming to number 84, it's get more exciting. Then we have the dogs that have clean runs from yesterday. We're still on the disqualified from yesterday. Next up, number 38 out of 145, Olga Edrova from Czech Republic with Adar.
This is also quite a big border collie. It was unfortunately a tunnel instead of the A-frame and an elimination. Yes, we're starting to get the results from yesterday that will means people who got through and are actually in the competition for the World Championship at number 50. But since we have so many zero faults from yesterday, I think you will have to have two clean runs to be World Championship this year. World Champion, of course. Oh, that's a nice dog walk. Look at that.
And you can see the dog is taking the tunnel instead of up on the A-frame. Number 39, Kazuto Kishimoto from Japan with the border collie Yamami.
And I think it's quite the adrenaline in this dog if you look at the body language.
Look at those ears.
Yeah, and the tail. So ready. Ooh, what a jump. And yeah, you could see
and
that already over number three that it was going to be the tunnel. The dog locked on it. Oh, what a nice weave entrance. Look at that.
Thank you, Japan. Number 40. And we can see the dog into the tunnel here. Number 40, Bernarda Jebus Redzik from Croatia with the Croatian sheepdog Kira.
Yes, and Kira is here on her third World Championships. She's actually 10 years old, which doesn't have to mean anything because the winner in medium is 10 and a half years old. And she's kind of quite tiny to run large, so she has to struggle with the heights. But still, she makes the time at the World Championships. That's pretty cool. She's after the split time with 1.5 seconds.
All the way down on the dog walk.
And over there, up. And she's clean. 41.50, clean round.
It's nice to have a clean round. It was a while ago.
Yeah.
Number 41, Shane Tang from China with the border collie Robin. Oh, wrong tunnel. We have 8 clean runs so far in this class, and we have 17 disqualifications.
She was so high on adrenaline and just wanted to take that tunnel, so it was the wrong entrance. Look at those. That seesaw, it's really nice. And into the weaves, looks really good too. And over there, she takes the long run. Works out fine. Over that one. Let's see the dog walk. Oh, that's a nice dog walk.
And let's hear the crowd. The arena is standing up. We're having our first Swede, Jenny Dum, and the border collie Lily.
And this is our queen of agility, you could say, here. And she was disqualified yesterday, but that does not mean that she can't be in the competition of winning today. And we know that Lily is a really fast dog, and Jenny is really good at tight turns and good ways. Look at that, from 7 to 9. And that's a good split.
And a really nice seesaw.
Oh, look at that weave entrance. I love her technique in the weaves. Through the tunnel, come on, Jenny. And the dog walk, now
and
you're gonna see
running.
Her running. Look at the running.
Ooh,
that was close, but she had a hit, and they are through. 38, 33. And the arena is cheering. Second place so far. Good one, Jenny. Look at that weave.
We still have Svetlana and Salsa from Latvia in lead. Second place, Jenny and Lili from Sweden. And on third place, Hiroshige and Lacey from Japan.
Now we have Rose Bailey Baumgartner from Canada with the Border Collie Bristol. Also a quite big Border Collie, but so far he looks like he can turn tight and nice, even though he's kind of big. And look at that seesaw, and that's a really good time. They had a split of 16:31, and the leader had 16:28.
No.
Oh, it's a five in the weaves.
It stepped out from the weaves.
Yes,
too early.
And it's eliminated.
Uh-oh, she forgot where she was going. Out from the dog walk, not the seesaw again.
That's a good dog walk. And her crowd is cheering. And here we see Andreas, our judge, in the picture.
And we can see when the dog steps out of the weaves here, it didn't took the last pole.
It was on his way forward, but then she turned a little bit too early and he turned with her.
On the course we have number 44 from Norway, Bård Iversen with Border Collie Sappa.
Nice on the A-frame, around there. Let's see, oh, that's a nice line over seven. Tight over nine. And quite a good split, 16:68.
The dog was almost aiming for number three again.
But they solved it nicely. Now they have to put up...
Lost dog.
No fault, but loss of time. And it's a hit on the dog walk up there. And it's a zero, 41:83.
Our Norwegian clean run. And let's see. There we have a hesitation in the weaves. Maybe we will see the hesitation after the tunnel. We have next up, number 45, Natalia Stenberg from Russia with the Border Collie Saki.
Yeah, they were a part of the silver team from Russia on Friday. And this is, oh no, that's a dropped fence.
Yeah, wing down.
Yeah, but this is actually one of the fastest dogs of this weekend so far on these courses. And the fence is up again. We have a beautifully arranged crew who are so good. So the fence is up.
Oh,
look at that dog walk. And they're through. Five folks, 37:76.
Oh my God, the Russians, they can't train dogs, can they? Number 46, Mišala Tomić from Serbia with Border Collie Gazela.
The time to beat is 37:52 for this round today. Which means a split time of 16:28.
And this is the Border Collie, which is all black, all over.
I think it has a... Oh, no, it was a five faults on the long jump. I think he has like a white spot between the forelegs.
Yeah, I can see it now. But it's really unusual to see a Border Collie this black.
Yeah, he has a white spot there. Over there, and let's see the dog walk. Looks like he's gonna have runnings. Oh yes, beautiful runnings. Up and over 21. Five folds, 39:89.
And we have number 47, Jeff Botello from the United States with Matrix, a Border Collie. Uh-oh.
That's a tunnel. It's hard to handle that kind of tunnel under the A-frame. It's all about discrimination of the obstacles,
and
as the dog knows.
We have seen 47 competitors so far, and this was our 20th elimination. So more than half of the teams are actually through this course.
Yes.
And as Andrea said when I talked to him before, you don't get a gold in the World Championships. You have to earn it.
And here we have Sergio Sousa from Portugal with Toby.
This is my absolute favorite handler this year.
Yeah.
Number 48, Sergio Sousa from Portugal with the golden retriever Toby. And they were amazing yesterday. He took down an obstacle with his hands. And Toby was like coming up into his arms after that and said, "I forgive you, Daddy."
Yeah, and they just ran the rest of the course and the crowd was cheering. And this lap has been all over Facebook and everybody loves this dog.
A refusal in the weaves, another refusal.
Now they're through.
And five.
Oh. And that's an elimination.
Sergio went between the weaves and that means you're disqualified. Only the dog are supposed to pass the weaves.
But this
or
dog,
any obstacle, and
yeah.
Sergio would know that because he did it yesterday.
But this dog is actually Swedish bred, but he's also competing in World Championships in both agility and obedience. This is a really good dog. He has been part of five Obedience World Championships.
And he has been catching every heart in here since yesterday.
Everyone
Mine
loves
too.
Him. And you could hear the crowd cheering before he went on.
Yeah. And we have number 49. Lili Foror from Hungary with Belgian Shepherd dog Damil.
And this is also quite a big dog, as you can see.
And he took two steps over the A-frame.
Yeah.
One on the first contact and one on the second.
Which means that when he has to brake and everything, it kind of gets a little bit big turns. And he would be greatest at the really fast tracks. Look at those weaves.
And also the hind paws for that dog.
Yeah, just as the other Belgian Shepherd. Over there, up the dog walk. Yeah, look at that dog walk. That's so nice. And 0 points, 41-13.
Look at those legs. And it takes one step at a time. And we're at the results. Number 50, Esther Booth from Netherlands with the Border Collie Mojo.
Yeah, so now we are technically competing for world champions.
Yes, yesterday they had 15 faults.
Yep.
We have 96 teams left.
Good save. Oh, that was a nice line over seven when he came, so on the six there. It's actually a really good split time. 16:43, leader had 16:28. See if it can catch up. It's a stop there. Hit on the dog walk. Over. And we're in. 0 points. 38-99. And you can see here what a good line he gets over number seven.
And we have number 51 from Luxembourg, Mike Peter, and the Border Collie Limit. Also 15 faults from yesterday.
Yes. And a five at the drop bar from first. Esther Booth and Mojo got up in the lead for the world champions. But as we said before, we have so many clear rounds that I don't think it will be enough to be world champion today. Look at those weaves. That's really beautiful. Through the tunnel. This is a fast dog. Unfortunately, the first drop bar. It's a five on the dog walk. 10 volts, 38, 13.
And we have...
Here you see the first bar. He gets off way too early and not able to get over this.
And we have number 52, Emily Abrahams from Australia with the Border Collie Loki. And Emily is actually the first Australian ever to compete in the World Championships.
Also a drop bar on the first.
Oh.
And an elimination. Yeah, and we got the information yesterday that she's from Sweden, and that's completely wrong. I'm very sorry for that. But she actually has gotten herself a trailer and moves around in Europe to be able to compete here. And that's very strong to do, I think. Then you really love agility. And that's what we're all here for, the love of the sport. Oh, now the run, yes. Almost made it, the crew, but not really. Good to move
and
away.
And what a running. The first Australian ever to compete in a world championship.
That's
how amazing.
Cool.
I hope we will see her next year again.
Yeah, I think so. She has a really good dog.
We have number 53 from Canada, Susan Garrett, and the Border Collie Momentum. And yesterday they had 12.62 faults.
Yes.
She was actually at the exact same time and faults as Emily Abrahams.
Nice way over seven. Look at those weaves. Over 14 through 15. Nice way over 16, 17. Oh, that's a drop bar. He didn't really get over that. Nice running. And the wall, and they are out. 5 falls, 39, 28.
We have number 54, Pavel Vakonic from Slovakia with the Border Collie Fiona.
And Pavel went very well in the small.
And here we have the standings so far. This is the combined. We have on 15 faults in the lead from now. Pavel had 10 faults from yesterday. Oh, we had a five on the A-frame.
Which means to get up in the lead, he has to take the time of 38.25, since the leader currently has 15 faults as well. And that's a misunderstanding, refusal, and then an elimination. But it's pretty cool to be part of two teams, both large and small, from his own country in World Champions.
And we have number 55. It's Femi Stoklis Orkopoulos from Greece with a Belgian Shepherd Dog Pisa. And this is their first. And Pisa, I think, is a really, really nice dog to watch. Five faults on the A-frame. But she moves really, really nice.
Look at that way over seven. That's really, really nice.
Uh-oh.
Five on the seesaw.
It was a flying seesaw. Saves time, though.
Yeah, look at that behind in the weaves. Just like two.
The other Belgians. Uh-oh, wrong
no,
side.
No, not at all at the other Belgians. Elimination. There.
Oh, what a nice dog walk. What a dog. She's beautiful.
And here we will see into the weaves. You can see, look at that behind. She uses both legs at exact same time.
Yeah.
And
number
now.
56, Redas Masilus from Lithuania with the Border Collie Grum.
A drop bar. Around there, up. up over 9 was really beautiful. Good seesaw.
They have 10 faults from yesterday.
But it's a good split time of 16.80, so they might... Oh, that's a big turn. I don't think they take the time.
Uh-oh. No.
A refusal and elimination.
He was so fast from the dog, so the dog hesitated if it was really going to take that tunnel entrance.
Yeah, and went away from it.
Two more dogs with 10 faults.
Yes.
Watch. And we have from France, number 57, Cynthia Perrier, and the border collie, Heros.
Nice over number 3. A hit on the A-frame.
And what a nice turn on the obstacle after the A-frame.
And if she goes clean here, she goes up in the lead, because the leader currently has 15 faults and she only has 10 with her from yesterday. Nice entrance to the weaves. And over there through 15. Come on. 16, round 17. Yes, up, 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 up on the dog walk. And a nice hit. God, that's a nice hit. Let's take the last two. And yes, she's in the lead.
Cynthia and Heros in the lead right now.
Here you get a really tight turn. Look at that dog.
Number 58, Natalia Denisenko from Ukraine with the border collie Roy.
Around there, yes.
And from yesterday, they had 10 faults.
So they now need a clean run and a time under 40.24.
Uh-oh.
That's a 5.
That's a flying seesaw there.
Yes, it is. Round there. Oh,
uh-oh.
He takes the
wrong way.
Works anyway, but loses a little bit of time. Round number 7.
Oh, what a nice turn on that obstacle up to the dog walk.
Nice dog walk.
Not even close to the long jump.
No. 5 points, 41.17.
And we have up next, number 59, Anna Winkel from Luxembourg with the Dutch Shepherd dog, Hoodie. And yesterday they had 7.09 in faults. So they were clean but had some time.
Yes. Let's see what they can do today.
Oh, the dog touched the long jump.
Yeah, but it not more.
Didn't fell.
Good seesaw. She's over a second after the split time, almost 2.5 seconds actually. But a clean run will take her to the lead. Over there and up there and the dog
nice
walk.
Nice turn up to the dog walk. Ooh,
yeah,
a high
was
hit.
A hit. And out, yes, it's 0 points, 44.22. Up in the lead. Let's see what she ends up with in total.
And we have number 60, Julia Fucci from Hungary with the border collie Teague.
Yes.
And yesterday they had 5 faults. And we have a lot of 5s from now on.
Yes. Anna and Hoodie went in on 7.31 in faults. That's when it was an elimination.
Let's see how many 5s we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Twenty-three fives total. So
yeah,
we have 22 left.
And next up is Lisa Frick, who is has a really fast dog, and as we know, she's really good at the World Championships. Oh, look, this is the dog with the fur.
With the running.
Yeah,
no, with the fur.
He's filled up with adrenaline, and yes, this is a running. Oh. No, oh, I don't know. Maybe not.
I talked to Tommy, which is a contact judge, and he said at the training that it was a Belgium brown border collie who had the fastest dog walk he had ever seen. So okay. I'm so looking forward to see a brown border collie from Belgium.
Yes.
And we have, let's see, number 61. And Lisa Frick bar. From Austria with the border collie Cody.
Yeah, but the drop bar at first. Look at her, nice. But she got it quite a big turn after the long jump, even though she really holds him tight there.
It's so quiet in here.
Yeah. 1.5 seconds Uh-oh. After in the split time.
5 faults in the weave. Missed one pole.
But now they are through. Right now she will end up in a second place, I think, with the fast 10. But that won't hold for long, I don't think. It's a hit on the dog walk. And they're through. 10 faults, 44.80.
And we have number 62. Jonathan Guillem Rodriguez from Spain with a border collie 3. And yesterday they had 5 faults.
So a clean run and they will go up in the lead for now. Oh, that's the entire jump. The dog really, really, really tried. Really good dog there, but it didn't manage. So a 5.
But a really nice long jump, just up and down,
yeah.
Low and nice.
And a really nice seesaw.
Tight to the ground.
Getting through the weaves nicely over there.
This big border collie has really, really tight turns.
Yeah, it's amazing. Let's see this. Yeah, it's a nice running. And over. 5 faults, 48.72.
And we have numbers, and let's see here. Look at that tight turn.
Yeah, he really tries, but I think he slips a little bit but just before he jumps off.
Number 63, Daniel Sevek from Croatia with the border collie Tau. And they also had 5 faults from yesterday.
Yeah. And I think the dog thought that he was a little bit in the way because he really, when he, oh, that's a 5 on the long jump. When he landed, he just said, woo, woo, woo. Or he just says, move, 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 I want to run. Look at that weave, that's really nice.
Uh-oh.
Oh, that's a misunderstanding. Over there, round and up, 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 up. Yes. It's a hit on the dog walk, it's a nice stop. And look, they're doing this nicely. It's 10 faults, 41.34.
And we have up next 64, Gabriela Ramirez from Colombia with Dundee. Also 5 faults from yesterday.
Also tight and nice of a number 3.
Oh.
A 5 on the A-frame. Yeah, a little bit too tight over the long jump. A 5. A seesaw.
Uh-oh.
Misunderstanding in the weaves.
15 faults so far.
Around there. Into the tunnel. Over there nicely. I haven't seen anyone take down 19 in a while. 15 faults, 44.23.
And number 65, Carlo Fazio from Italy with the border collie Hindia. And they also have 5 faults from yesterday. Uh-oh.
Drop bar number 3, a little bit too tight.
And a 5 on the A-frame. And a lost dog.
But it
picked
out.
It up.
And nice over 7 again. That's the other dog who got the same way. Well, he got a hit on that. Oh, he chooses that way. And it worked.
It worked.
It worked. tenfold so far. But a really nice run. Good hit. Look at that dog, it just does everything to get over the obstacles. Tenfold, 40.98.
I guess we have a Belgium upcoming, because the crowd on our left gets really excited. Number 66, Mark van Beek from Belgium with the Border Collie Gem.
And to get in the lead of this class, you have to have a time of 37.52. To take a lead for him, he just needs a clear round.
That doesn't even look hard. Let's see the dog on the dog walk. Ooh, a high hit.
But it's a hit. And they are clear. 39, 45, and up in the lead. So from now on, you have to have clean runs if you have a five from the beginning to get in the top three.
And we have number 67 from Denmark, Morten Juul Hansen, with the Border Collie Guideline.
Nice over three, up over four. Let's see how he does over seven. Yeah, that's really tight. But a big turn afterwards. And the seesaw, yes, it's not the best made split time, but I think it will be enough to take the lead if he goes clean. Nice over that one, and let's see the dog walk. It's a five. And they are through. Let's see if he can get in on third place so far. He had 39.82 in time. And five
and we have number 68, Katerina Povalicheva from Russia with the Border Collie DZ.
And he got in on the fourth place, Morten. And she has also five faults from. And it's a clean run, 38.99, which should put her in the lead.
And we have number 69, Marilyn Raby, with the Border Collie Nila from France.
And she has to have a clean run and the time 38.99 to get in the lead right now.
Lost dog.
Nice over seven and eight and nine. A little bit of a hesitation there though. Nice seesaw. Ooh, she got out of the way. Look at that weave entrance. A little bit after in the split time, but it should be enough for the leading time if she gets clean here.
Uh-oh.
It's a five.
It's like the dog fell off the dog walk.
Yeah. 39.19 and five faults.
Number 70, Polona Bonak from Slovenia with Border Collie Lean.
That was another handling technique.
Uh-oh.
And that was the tunnel.
We have three dogs left, then we're going to have a break. Two or three.
And in the start of the break there, you will get an updated list on the current ranking of the World Championships. Look at this dog. It's amazing.
Oh, what a running!
And nice on the obstacles after.
And we have number 71, Marcela Cecchia from Brazil with the Border Collie Angel. She also has 5 faults from yesterday.
Which means she needs a clean run and a fast run under 39.29 to be able to get in the lead right now.
Oh, she has 2 dropped bars, one at the long jump.
One at the other obstacle, but
and
look at that nice
a frame
seesaw.
Again means elimination.
But that seesaw was really nice, and look at that weave. Nice dog walk.
Number 72, also with 5 faults from yesterday, Natalia Sternberg from Russia with the Border Collie Prima.
One of the fastest dogs I know.
Yeah, and let's see what she does with Prima. She's already run the course with her other dog.
And I think her other dog is actually the fastest of the two.
A little bit of hesitation in front of the long jump.
I'm impressed that she got
over it. Oh, what a seesaw.
Yeah, this dog is amazing. Look at that weave. And over there, through the tunnel, not many obstacles left. Oh, what a nice line there.
Oh.
The hit over there.
And what a time.
And they're through. 39-13.
And we have number 73 from Great Britain, Martin Reed, and the Border Collie Spring.
So hit on the A-frame. Over 5 nicely, 6 and 7. Look at the dog turning after number 7. Drop bar at number 9. Through the tunnel nicely. Good through the weaves. Close to that bar too, but it was still on. Let's see the dog walk.
Oh!
Yes. And it's a 5 with 38.77.
And we're having a break, and we're going to watch the standings. The combined standings so far, very soon on the screen.
There they are. As you can see, we have Natalia Sternberg with Prima first on 5 faults and a good time. Katarina Povalisheva and Mark van Beek also on 5, and then we have a little bit more faults. But I don't think this will be enough for the complete standings because we have so many clean runs from yesterday.
And we have our mascots on stage, Lagom and Fika. There it.
So this will be a short break. It's 7 minutes left, and then we will be back. See you then. Welcome back to this World Championship Finals Individual Large in Agility. And we are having a break. It's about half a minute left, and then we will see the rest of the dogs. We are currently starting at number 74, and that is Daria Skrykpitsia from Ukraine with Angel. And you can see the Swedish crowd dancing. So it's quite a technical course today. It's no really, not really any part where you can just relax and run. You have to really, really be technical all the time. We have, let's see how many there are left. 10 more dogs with 5 poles from yesterday, and then we're going in on the 62 dogs with 0 poles. And then it will be really exciting, because then, as soon as someone has 2-0 rounds, it will be all about the time, and we will keep you as updated as we can, we promise.
We have seen 73 dogs so far. We have a total of 16 clean runs, and we have 29 eliminated dogs. So it's a good course, 50-50 quite.
Yeah, Andreas usually makes really good courses. We know who usually competes for him here in Sweden. I'm feeling that my voice is getting weaker and weaker, but I'm hoping that we are able to keep you updated throughout this class. It's about 74 dogs left.
And you can see the next dog sneaking out and looking at the course and the dancing. I can't really sit still here in this arena with this music. And all the French on our left side, which are dancing all the time. And look at that dance.
The clock is up. Tommy, our judge of contacts, are waiting. So we're soon to be starting again. We just need to fix the last couple of details.
Yeah, our contact judge, Tommy Hagström, is already ready at the course. We're just waiting for Andreas to show up, and he is here.
And Tommy, he are the judge of the ups of the dog walk. And then Andreas.
And we can also see Kristina Mirfelt here in picture. She's also a Swedish judge.
And she's one of the ones responsible for the
course.
Judge area. Yeah.
She's the course boss.
Yeah, she is.
Actually, Kristina Mirfelt and our another judge, Åsa Vrede, is our bosses for the course this week.
Yes, they've been doing a great job. So let's take in number 74.
Yeah, Daria Skryptitsia from Ukraine with Shed.
And a drop bar, two drop bars. She had 5 faults with her from yesterday. So to go up in the lead right now, she needed 0 faults and a good time.
We have 9 dogs left with 5 faults.
A really good weave entrance there. And over. And into the tunnel, and up over there, through that one. See the dog walk? It was a hit. And they are through at 10 faults, 39-44.
And we have number 75, Masa Seglar from Slovenia with the Border Collie Maggie. Uh-oh.
A drop bar at number one. She really got off wrong there. Nicely over 7 and through 8-9. It's also a good line. She has a really good split time, but sadly that won't be enough when she has a drop bar. Nicely over there. It's a clean hit.
She like bumped into the dog after the dog walk.
5 faults, 39-53.
There we can see the start and the bar that dropped. And we can see the bump here. Didn't bump, but the dog did break to not bump into her handler.
Yeah.
And we have number 76, Algirdas Valsiukas with Border Collie Rose from Lithuania.
A hit on the A-frame. A hit on the long jump and a drop bar.
And a 5 on the seesaw.
Yeah. 15 folds so far and a refusal in the weaves.
First refusal. 20 folds.
I really like the look of this dog. 5 there as well. And we are through. 41, 35, 25 folds.
Number 77. Anastasia Lobanova from Russia with the Border Collie Joker. And let's see what this Russian can do with this course. They have been really good so far from Russia.
Nice and tight over 7. Good line to 8-9, but he has to break a little bit in the turns, which has to lose him some time. Split time of 17:56, so he's after. But a clean run so far. Round there. And he's over, 39:51, 0 folds. Which puts them in the lead with 5 folds and total time of 74:55 in the lead of the championship right now.
And we have number 78, Christian Friend from Switzerland with the Border Collie Braveheart.
Nicely over there. Good on the A-frame. He almost flipped over, but it went well. Quite a big line there. This is also a Border Collie with very long legs. A good split time. Let's see what he can do. He has to have 0 faults and 39:55 to go up in the lead right now. And to win this class, he has to have a time better than 37:52. Oh, what a dog walk. Over, and it's a 37:39 up in the lead of this class and in the lead of the championship right now.
He took a double lead so far, as Emma said. And we have 79, Wayne Arniel from South Africa with the Border Collie Rage. A little hesitation into the first tunnel. Let's see if the dog gets up on the A-frame and all the way down. It was on. Andreas pointed his finger to the A-frame to tell everyone that the dog was on. Drop bar, 5 faults.
But a good split time.
A refusal to the tunnel.
Nice entrance to the weaves, though.
10 faults so far.
And
one
nice
drop
and
bar
tight over there.
And one refusal.
In on 16, over 17. Let's watch the dog walk. It's
no.
A hit.
It was down on the A-frame and on the dog walk. The dog was down.
Yeah. 10 folds, and I did not get the time there.
We have number 80, also 5 folds from yesterday. David Codbu from Montenegro with the Border Collie Boomer.
And they have
Bomber. And we have top 3 up in the left corner, everyone with 5 faults.
Yeah, and that's the top 3 for the championship. And this dog has to go in on a clean run. And with the time, 37:88 or under to get in the lead for the championship right now. But that's an elimination. Wrong jump instead of the tunnel.
Seen 80 dogs and 30 eliminated ones. So more dogs are through than eliminated at this final course at the Agility World Championship 2018.
Yeah. And it's a complicated course with really nice lines, just as Andreas used to make them. So I'm thinking that this is a really fun course to run. It looks really fun. Let's take in Great Britain.
Yeah, we're going to see number 81, Sian Illingworth from Great Britain with the Border Collie Image.
But first they are discussing something here, the judge and the people from Gallican who has delivered our fences and times. Are cheering on their next contender in the meantime while we're waiting. She's in the starting arena just waiting for her turn. Now they're satisfied with the obstacles and the timing. Now let's go.
And as I said, we have number 81, Sian Illingworth from Great Britain with the Border Collie Image.
And this is a really cool Border Collie. Look at her move. Nice. On the
She's
A-frame.
Moving so low between the obstacles.
She's so fast.
She's so close to the surface. Oh,
drop bar.
Another one. 10 faults total.
Good weaves. Oh, look at that. How did she manage to get over that? Oh, what a dog walk. And they're through. 10 folds, 37, 73. A good time. But 10 folds.
The last dog with 5 folds from yesterday. We have 2 dogs left with folds. First out, a number 82, Nina Gregel from Croatia with the Border Collie Vise.
And Vis is a really cool dog, a really fast dog. Nina really knows how to handle. And Vis has currently been injured, and she's now back after a long rehab. And she got so far out on number 7, so it was the straight line for 8 was on the inside. But Vis is currently back now after an injury, and Nina says that she's faster than ever. Let's see this dog walk. Nice, really nice stop. Oh, that's good. And they're fixing the wall because Vise was in it, but not taking it down.
And there you can see the dog came in on the jump after the long walk way too fast. But like Nina said, the dog is way faster than before.
Yeah. And when you get so far out to the left on the long jump, this is the fastest way over number 8.
Yeah, and we have number 83. No, it can't be. It's number 84. Karin Popovičkova with the Border Collie Blaze from Slovakia. And they are clean from yesterday, so we're in the clean rounds.
Yeah.
I think we had one competitor that didn't show up.
Number 83.
Number 83
is out.
Didn't show up.
Let's see here, she's 5
and
so
I know
far.
Why. And if she has a clean run, she's up in the lead.
But she didn't, because she had a 5, but and time 41.63.
Oh, there we have the drop bar.
Yeah.
Yeah, and this is why we didn't see Kiss Who as number 83. It's because Kiss Who is a song from China is running right now.
With a dog without faults, the other dog had faults, so he's yeah. taking
and
his chances
Jenny
with this one.
And it's Jenny Niu.
And I understand why he can't run two dogs so tight. Oh, that's a five. Misunderstand. Oh, and a drop part more. Nice seesaw. And good into the weaves. Look at that weave. Through the tunnel. Let's see the dog walk. It's a stop. Uh-oh. Oh, and he got another drop bar. He didn't get over that one.
15 faults total.
Yeah, and time 42.88.
Next up, we have 86 from Brazil. Moab Mordomio with Border Collie Reiva.
It's going to be fun to see this dog. I'm quite in love with another dog from Brazil, a little brown pumi who went in medium.
Moody.
Sorry, of course, a Moody. Sad over that seven. It was really nice and tight. Another drop bar. 10 faults so far. Nice to the tunnel. Good weave. Over that one. And around there. It's a five on the dog walk. So 15 faults, 39.32.
And we have number 87 up next. Yao Xiang with the Border Collie Burton from China. And they are clean from yesterday, as everyone from now.
To get up in the lead, they can afford one bar down or one missed contact because they can have a five and a really good time.
But not an elimination.
No.
You can't get a world championship with an eliminated run.
And even if they had just won five, I don't think it will be enough since we have so many clear rounds yet to go from yesterday.
Yeah, we have 58 dogs left. 58. Clean runs left. This is going to be exciting till the last dog and I think the last obstacle. And we have number 88. David Rodriguez from Colombia with the Border Collie K.
And look at that dog looking at his owner. Can we go soon, please?
And this dog is the dog with the beautiful spots in its face.
Yeah, this is so cute. It's a nice hit. Up over seven. Quite a big turn. Over nine. And the seesaw is a hit. He's a bit off the split time from the leader of the class, but with the zero, he will get in the lead for the championship.
The dog kind of stopped in the weaves.
Yeah.
At the beginning. Uh-oh, lost dog.
But it works. Through there, let's see the dog walk. Still clear. Not the best time, though. That's a five on the dog walk.
The dog got off on the side of the dog walk.
45, 30, 5 faults.
And here you can see the little bit of stop in the weaves. The dog was asking if it was going to go through. And here is the lost dog. But he picked it up quite good. And we have number 89. It's Natalia Vodronshanova from Ukraine with the Border Collie Rico.
Yeah, and she did a really long start to get him in speed and good over the first obstacle.
They were on
nice
57th place yesterday.
7 to 8 was really good. And over there, through the tunnel, into the weaves. Yeah, looks good. She has to have zero faults and then she gets up in the lead If she gets a 5, she has to beat the time 34.94. She's clear so far. And the first double clear.
And we have 2 clean runs in the lead right now. Natalia and Rico from Ukraine.
In time.
And up next, number 90. Rob Hall from South Africa again with this time. The border collie Milo.
And this means that you have to have 2 clear rounds to win the championship of 2018 in large.
A drop bar.
A drop bar. Five faults, 41.80.
Number 91, Olar Kivilo from Serbia with the border collie Tuffy.
And they're off. Five on the A-frame.
And a lost dog. Wrong way on number 5.
There you can see it was really good. Since the dog came out so long, he would have been able to go inside the 8, but the handler stopped so long to show him the outside, and that was really smart.
We have 5 faults on the seesaw.
So 10 faults in total so far. But we have to remember that it's just 5 again on the dog walk. It's just amazing. They're on the world championship. They're running the world championship. It's amazing. And here we have someone from Belgium, I think, since there are neighbors on the arena and the cheering is loud.
We have Loic Cusumano from Belgium with the border collie Molly. They were on 54th place
from
yesterday.
Oh, look at that 3. So nice over that 3. I'm so impressed that he can run with the hat, because I always drop my hats when I have tried to run with them. Look at the way over 9. It's a really good split time. No, it's a 5. A little too soon from the weaves. Through there. Up and over, and let's see the dog walk.
the dog almost dropped off.
Yeah.
But it sold it good, but it got a 5.
Yeah. 10 faults, 42.60. But a good dog to be able to
rescue. We can shake this dog walk where the dog slipped its paw, but did manage to pick it up again and not fall off. Number 93. Marie Piroja from Estonia with the Belgian Shepherd dog, Susie.
And she has to have 0 faults and run under the time of 40.13. And it's a good split time. It's almost the same as the leader of the class who went in on 37.52. So she should be able to take the time if she just holds on to the dog.
Oh, what a nice turn.
Oh, what a nice dog. Did you see those hind legs? Nice. 0 faults, 40.64. So under the time. Here you can see how...
Look at those hind legs.
Yeah, she just... Whoa! And she got over.
She picked those legs up a little extra. And we have another Belgian Shepherd dog, this time Sorrow from Finland with the owner Kim Kurkinen. And they were in 52nd place yesterday. The wing there.
Maria and Susie went in on 2nd place, 0 faults, 77.73 in time. These have to go in on zero faults and time 40:27. They are off in the split time, so let's see what they can do on the rest of the course. This is a really cool dog. They have so much fur, these breeds. And let's see the dog walk. It's a beautiful
it's
hit.
Amazing.
God, what a dog walk. And they're through at 40:40, so they don't make the time, but it's a beautiful round.
I think it's a second place.
Yes, it is. Cayman Sorrow went in on a second place with 77:35 in total. The leader has 77:22.
And we have number 95, Lila Chocol from Hungary with border collie Cassie.
And they have to have a clean run with the time 40:37 or below to take the lead. Nice way over seven, but a little too long turn to eight. It's a split time over a second after the leader in the class, but it will still make the time of the championship if she... Oh, no! That's a misunderstanding and a refusal. I think that she tried to get away a little bit too early. She wanted to rush away and just one thousand of a second or something. She went away too fast. Five faults, 43:69.
And up next, number 96, Anja Blasevic from Croatia with the Croatian sheepdog Buha.
And Buha is a rescue dog from the beginning. And they have only been doing agility for 2.5 years, if I remember correctly. And Anja is 14 years old. That's pretty amazing. And that's a pretty good time, almost a second after the leader, but they will still make 40:45, which they have to take the lead.
Uh-oh, a nice little round. Bit of hesitation on the obstacle before the dog walk, but they made it.
And it's a hit on the dog walk, and up, and yes, they made it.
40:45 were the time to beat, and they have 40:04. So right up in the lead for Anja and Buha from Croatia.
Champions
double up from Croatia. And we have number 97. It's Christos Balasopoulos from Greece with the border collie Mio. And the time to beat is 40:10.
Nice in there, through the weaves. He has to beat the time of 40:10. Up the dog walk. It's a five on the up. It's a five on the up on the dog walk. It's the first dog I've seen. 40:19 and the five.
We have number 98, Michelle Weber from France, with the dog Hindi, a border collie.
Got a hit on the A-frame. Nice way over seven, but drops a little bit thereafter and slips. But still a good time. Although he slipped, he got a good time. What a dog. It's a split of 16:66, and the leader had 16:28. So this is a time of 37-something, and she has to beat 40:11. It's a hit. Round there. Up, up, up. And yes, 39:59 in the lead.
And we have Sweden is up next.
Yeah, and the arena is cheering and roaring.
Number 99, Ebba Eriksson and the border collie Jazz.
And they're already off. They're doing offensive agility today. No, that's the tunnel. And the crowd is cheering her to the goal. Look at these two, it's a beautiful run.
This is their first championship.
And they have done it beautifully, I think. It's not easy to do a world championship on the home arena for the first time.
And we have top three at the screen. All three have two clean runs.
Look at that.
So it's a clean run to get on the podium today.
And here you can see the tunnel where Ebba and Jazz take the tunnel instead of the A-frame.
Up next, number 100. Anna Pospisilova from Slovakia with the border collie Ruka.
Time to beat is 39.73 and 0 faults. No, he managed to get over 7.
Yeah, he kind of tripped somehow in the air.
I'm so over the long jump. Over so many dogs who just like, oh, this is not going to work. Yeah, I sold it. Nice and tight. Look at that dog. In there, around over there, up the dog walk. Yes! Oh. God, what a nice dog walk. And they have it, 39.04 and in the lead. This puts pressure on next.
I think we're going to say in lead a lot right now. We have 45 dogs left and all are clean from yesterday.
Yeah, but the times are getting more and more difficult to beat.
101, Sissy Graf from Austria with the border collie, Jeremy.
Yeah, and they have the time to beat, 39.08. And they have a good split time to be able to beat the time. With that stop, it takes them a little bit of time though, and 40.18 does not make the lead.
Oh, I hear we have a birthday girl at the course. We have number 102, Desiree Snelleman from the United States with the border collie crew.
Nice over there. And almost a misunderstanding, but they solved it nicely. Through. Oh, what a nice turn of a 9.
Oh, look seesaw. At that seesaw.
And it's a great split.
Uh-oh.
Oh, it's a refusal.
A second refusal, it takes too much time. And a third means elimination.
As longer we come in the start list, we get more and more time to play with since they were fast yesterday. But if someone puts in a really, really, really fast run, it will be hard.
And we have number 103 from Spain, Adrian Bajo Alonso with the border collie Sucre.
And the Spain part of the arena is really loud right now. Oh, what a dog. This is speed. Nice over number 3. He takes that side. Around 5, 6, and nice over 7. Tight there. Really tight over 9, and a good seesaw.
The time to beat is 39.47.
And right now, if he keeps up with this kind of speed, he will end up with something on 37.38, I think, with the split time. Oh, what a dog walk! That's nice! And 38.26.
He cuts the time a lot there.
Yeah.
So it will be harder for his competitors to take the time.
Yeah, now we're down at 38. 8 if you want to beat this.
Yes, 104. Karina Grigore from Latvia with Border Collie Gepa.
And they have the time 38:31 to beat, and of course a clean run. Oh, look at the dog over that fence.
After this,
nice.
We have 41 dogs to go.
This is a beautiful dog, but he almost pushes him or herself a little bit too hard on the jumps and almost tumbles after many jumps.
Yeah, and that takes a lot of time, as we can see.
That's five. But it's a good time, 38.99. 5 folds.
And we have number 105 from Switzerland, André Mühlebach, with the Border Collie Lynn.
Nice over three, up on four. It's a hit. Yes, there. Around the long jump, a pretty long turn though.
He followed the dog
and
all the way to the long jump.
Yeah. A drop bar. Five folds. Oh, that's a nice weave entrance and a nice weave technique for the dog. And they were in goal with 38.93 and a drop bar, 5 folds.
We're at place 40 from yesterday, and it's 106. Selko Gora from Croatia with the Belgian Shepherd dog, Gunga.
And Gunga has done many world champions with Selko, so this arena is not hard for them as an arena, but the course might be. Time to beat, let's see, is 38.55 if they want to take the lead. That was a miss in the slalom, I think, in the weaves.
Yeah, and
a nice dog walk. Look at that dog walk.
Yeah, but up on the dog walk wasn't that good, so I think he would have a 5. Let's see the weaves. Yeah.
Yeah, she misses the last pole.
Yeah. And Andreas was actually not sure, but sometimes you have to think about the sequence a little bit,
yeah,
and then you can see it in your head. We have number 107, Henk Timme from Netherlands, with the Border Collie Feng.
This is a small, light Border Collie, as far as we can see from here, and it does the tight turns really beautifully. Nice seesaw, and a drop bar. Over there, let's see the dog walk. Yeah, it's a good hit. Up, over, and over. 5 folds, 40.63.
And we have 108 from France, Christophe Dalmat, with Border Collie Haston.
And time to beat for them is 38.66. Nice on the dog walk, around there, up over 6, and 7 tight and nice. Good seesaw. Split time about a second after the leader of the class, but still should manage the time on that. Over there, let's see the dog walk. Oh, that's a hit.
It's a high hit, but it's a hit.
Yeah, and it's a long turn, and they're losing some time. So 40.64, 0 folds.
And we have 109, Stanislav Kuroshkin from Russia with a border collie Sipi.
And here is another favorite of many today. He has done beautiful rounds, and the dog is just amazing with reading his signs. Oh, beautifully over there. Nice. She's so tight, she just turns in the air. Oh, nice seesaw, and the split time is great. And he takes the backside of the tunnel, and these weaves, and this dog, it's just amazing. Around there, and he can run, even though she's...
Catch that dog up!
Oh, look, how beautiful is this! And the time! 37.08! God, what a time! And he puts a lot of pressure on the next couple of dogs.
I don't know what to say, actually.
No, and even though he was after in the split time, he was way ahead in the end.
This is outstanding. This is just... how does he manage to do that?
Yeah,
we have 110, Patricia Ciferri from Italy with the Border Collie B.
Clean so far. Let's see what she can do with this course. But Stanislav's dog is so precise and tight. Oh, that's a drop bar. So I think that's what he wins the time on, really.
Do I need to say that Stanislav and Sipi are in the lead?
Oh, I don't think so.
No, they're in the lead, both in the class and in the total.
Look, what a nice dog walk over there. And they had to take a time of 37.12, and they have 39.16 and 5.4.
And it's good. We have a Swede up on course. And I need that because I need to drop that race from Stanislav. We have Joni Orenius, and the border collie Nila. And
they have to be faster than 37.13. Oh, it's a 5 on the A-frame.
Nila is a really small border collie. And Joni is really fast.
Yeah.
My best friend says he's dancing on the course.
This is a beautiful run. Nila is a great dog. They've done many championships together, these two.
Uh-oh, a 5 on the dog walk.
So, and 10 faults and 39.01.
This championship is nothing for him. He's going to be a father really soon.
Yeah, and that's the biggest title you'll ever get, I think. Now we have Olivier Manertz from Belgium with Keen, a border collie.
We have 34 dogs to go.
Yeah, and he has to have beat the time of 37.16. Stanislav and Sipi really put a hard pressure on the rest of the dogs. And the Russian team got silver on Friday. And they are clean so far. Around there. Up the dog walk. It's a hit. Around, and he will not make the time. 38.29. Let's see what he ends up in place here.
Up next, we have 113, Thomas Berger from Austria with the border collie Echo. And they were in place 33 yesterday.
And they have to beat the time 37.17. Olivier Manertz and Keane went in on a second place with 0 in time and 73.85 in total. Stanislav and Sipi has a total time of 72.72. 0 faults.
And this dog...
Oh, look at those weeds!
Yeah, but look at this dog. It's everywhere. Yeah. Look at when it's jumping. It has one paw in each corner.
Yeah.
Look.
It does everything to get over these obstacles. What a dog.
Uh-oh. It touched the last bar, but it didn't drop.
39.45, zero faults.
We have number 114 from Poland, Iwona Golab, with border collie applause.
And time to beat for these two are 37.21. And Thomas Berger ended up for now on a fourth place with Echo. On a total time of clean 75.
Oh.
And that's a really good split time. Keep this up.
Took quite a long time in the weaves.
Yeah. Nice over there. Let's see the dog walk.
Oh.
It's a beautiful hit. A little bit long time in the break there. And ends up at 39.09.
Which
zero
isn't
points.
Enough to
no.
get up in the first place.
Stanislav put a real high pressure on everyone who is left.
Yeah, applause got in on a fourth place so far. We have up next Shani Elmstedt from... no, it's not.
This has to be Jessica Patterson.
This is Jessica Patterson from Canada with the border collie tricks.
Yes. And they have to beat the time of 37.24.
Yeah, they have split the place with Shani. That's why I was wrong.
And they have a split time almost a second after the leader.
Yeah, and we're going to watch Jessica Patterson run with her other dog in the end of this class.
Yes, because she's very high up there.
Yeah, two or three, I think.
Yeah. And over, and they are in on zero faults, 40.27. Now we have Denmark.
Now we have Denmark. Shani Elmstedt. With the border collie Mayday. And let's see what Shani and Mayday can do.
Yes, they also have to beat the time 37.24, but they got a drop bar. It's a nice weave entrance, but then it got a little bit misunderstanding.
And she chooses to take the whole sequence
good
again
dog.
To
look
make it right.
Weave. Through there, up over 16, 17, and the dog walk. And
a high hit.
Yeah. And now we have
29 dogs left. Number 117, Roberta Boscolo, Gioacchina from Italy with border collie Roger.
And they have to beat the time of 37.36. And Stanislav's time on this course was 37.08.
Uh-oh.
Oh, that's the obstacle from the wrong way and elimination.
We have 28 dogs left.
Yes. Beautiful weave entrance. Up over the fence, through the tunnel. And from where we sit, you can really see the dog running on the sides of the tunnel. And a beautiful dog walk up over the wall with a really nice turn when she did that handling technique.
And we have
Finland into the course.
Yeah, Tuulia Liuto with the border collie Pirtu. Number 118.
And they have to beat the time of 37.40 to get in the lead. was a hit on the A-frame. Andreas nodded. And they had a split time of 17 exactly, and I don't think it's really good enough to take the time, but you never know what happens in the end. It's
no,
a hit.
I don't think with a stop dog
no.
work you're going to take this.
Not today. 40-44 in time, and zero faults. We have some problems with the live results, that's why you don't see the lists in the view here. But they're trying to fix it, and during that time we will update you as good as we can.
Yeah, we have number 119, Anke Bauer from Austria, with the Australian Kelpie, Lia.
And current standing in the totals are Stanislav Kuroshkin with Sipi, Olivier Manuel with Keen, and Adrian Barru Alonso with Sucre from on 1, 2 and 3. Looks good so far. Let's see what they can do here. It's a hit both up and down, but it's a drop bar. And time 40-12. There's a lot of traffic on the live results, so that's why it does not really
last 25
right
dogs.
Now.
Tanya Fendrich from Switzerland with a Border Collie Phoenix. This is
a long way over number three, and that's the tunnel.
This is not Tanya, this is Alar Kivilio from Serbia with the Border Collie Trygg.
Yes.
See my papers. Yes, they were at the same time from yesterday. That's why I read it wrong.
And as said before, the live results are not really cooperating with us, and that's due to a lot of traffic on the live results, which is of course understandable. We all want to see them, but right now we can't see because too many people are looking, and the traffic is too hard for the side. Not so strange in the individual finals.
And we have now we have Tanya Fendrich from Switzerland with the Border Collie Phoenix.
Time to beat is 37:47. Nice hit on the A-frame. Over there, through, yes, over nine. It's a nice line there. It's a good split time, 16:32. Stanislav had 16:79, but then he picked up the speed on the last part.
The time to beat, 37:47.
Yes, that's a nice hit, but she won't make the time. 39:20, zero faults.
And we have number 122, Barbara Skarnitslova from Czech Republic with the Border Collie Brook.
And they have the time to beat, 37:51. And Tanya and Phoenix went in on a fourth place so far. They are almost a second after the split time. Let's see what they can do. That's a good dog walk. But they're not making the time. 39:88, zero faults.
We have 23 dogs left. Next up, Alexandra Gronek from Poland with the Border Collie Deal. First place, still Russia, Stanislav and Sipi. Second from Belgium, Oliver and Keane. And third, Spain, Adrian and Sucre.
Time to beat for these two are 37.69.
Uh-oh.
That's a refusal on the long jump.
Yeah, the dog cheated on the long jump.
Which means that they are out of the running of the championship. And they got a second refusal. And now she takes it from the tunnel and they are eliminated.
22 dogs left. Before we know who will be the individual large champion 2018. And we have up next Natalia Loginova from Latvia with the Border Collie Chile.
And they have the time to beat 37.70. So the time is getting a little bit more for each dog since they had a faster time yesterday, but it's still not long. You still have to ace this course to beat the time. Nice turn. Nice on number 7.
Yeah, and because of Sippy's fast run, you almost need to do the run of your life to get this, get the time.
I think Stanislav and Sippy made their run of their life, maybe. Since they didn't have that fast time from yesterday, but still are in the lead with such a good time now. It was a hit on the dog walk. They're not making the time, though. Ends up at 39.30, 0 volts.
We have Sara Penasaro from Italy with the Border Collie Alisa. Up next. They're off.
Nice around 3. A 5 on the A-frame. And that means they're out of the running of the championship for this year. Oh, that was a nice save from the dog. He almost turned 90 degrees on the spot. Was a hit. And they are through at 5 volts, 39.93.
Number 20 from yesterday, Veronika Kralikova from Slovakia with the Border Collie B.
And the time to beat, as far as I can see here, are 37.86. And Stanislav and Sipi had 37.08. And they did a phenomenal run. They are... that's a drop bar. Otherwise, a really good split time.
The dog came in such a high speed and jumped off a little bit too early to get that jump good enough.
It's a hit on the dog walk. And they are through, 5 volts, 39.06.
We can see the dog there dropped all of the back. And we're up number 18 from yesterday, Lisa Frick from Austria with the Border Collie Jack. And the time to beat, 37.87.
And Lisa and Jack can be really fast. That we know, it was a hit on the A-frame.
This is not Lisa. This is Susan Koldenhoff from Netherlands with the Border Collie Time.
Yes, it is.
They had a split place from yesterday. And I just have the results list from yesterday from now on, because now it's getting really exciting.
She might make the time.
37.87. And she won't make the time.
38.55. Better get around. And it takes her into second place so far.
And we're going to watch Lisa Frick from Austria with a Border Collie Jack.
This is also a fast team, and they have to beat the time of 37.87.
Yeah, and they were at place 18 yesterday together with Susan and Time. So let's see who's faster today.
Nice over number 7. Good change there. It's a really good split time, the fastest today, 16.06. Let's see what she can do to the total time. Come on, Jack.
Nice turn.
Up, 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 and down. It's a hit.
37.87.
And she does it, 37.86. She makes it with one split second. 37.86.
It's just hundreds. It's just hundreds. And she
should end up. No.
No, she got into a second place.
No.
How is that possible? The time is not right. She's on the first place. She has a better time than Stanislav and CP. Next
one
up, Marge Schmidt from Estonia with the Border Collie Faye. I can see they're counting downstairs.
Looks good so far.
The time, there we have a 5.
That's a good 38.04. 5.
Next up, number 16 from yesterday, Anthony Guillemot from France with the Border Collie Enox.
Time to beat, 37.96. And as we have seen, it's doable, but it's hard. You really have to fight for this gold today. It's a 5. And the time, 37.58. So he would have made the time.
And we have number 15 from yesterday, Silvia Trakman from Slovenia with Border Collie 2.
Time for them to beat is 38.06, and if it's something we know about Sylvia, it's that she is fast. Looks good so far. Up there.
Means disqualification for 2. And let's see this dog walk. I don't think it was a hit, actually. And now we have from Poland, Monika Rylska and the Border Collie Chica. The time to beat is 38.14.
It was a hit on the A-frame.
In the lead, Lisa Frick and Jack. Second, Stanislav and Sippy. And third, Susan and Time.
And as said, between one and two, it's only 100 that is separating them. Let's see the dog walk. It's not a hit. It's a five. And the time, 38:28.
Next up, also on place 13 from yesterday, Masanori Kaitora from Japan with a border collie Conan.
It's a drop bar so far, so they're out of the title. But let's see what they can do with the time. It's a touch there. And they have a beautiful time at 37:83. But five folks.
Number 12 from yesterday, Marje Piruja from Estonia with the Belgian Shepherd dog Dintz. And the time to beat is 38:15.
It's a five on the A-frame. They're out of the competition for the title. That's a nice tunnel entrance and a nice weave entrance from Dintz. This is a good dog. Oh, what a nice and tight turn. It's a hit on the dog walk. And with a stop on dog walk, she still manages to get 38:73. That's a good time.
It means this dog is really, really fast, and it uses its long legs to take a lot of ground on the course. Eleventh place from yesterday, Serve Gottschalk from Netherlands with the border collie June.
And the time to beat are 38:19. And this is a fast little dog as well, but a long turn there. It's a good split. He should be able to make the time on that split.
What an offensive weave entrance from the dog there.
This is a beautiful dog. And up over the dog walk. Oh. It's a five. And the time ends up at 38:98. Five folks. Now the Germans are cheering in the arena, because here we have Germany.
And it's Max Spintz from Germany with the border collie Bex.
And they have the time to beat 38:19. Oh, nice, but a little bit high. Oh, she manages that. That was almost that she fell over. Little bit of a big turn up there. Let's see what they can do with the time. It's quite a good split, but they have to keep it up this time. Good weave. Nice and tight. Do the tunnel. Come on, Bex. Let's see a nice dog walk. Oh, that is a nice dog walk. But will they make the time? No, 38:29, 10 hundredths off. But it was a really nice turn. And we have give them the bronze so far.
Also on place 9 from yesterday, Sylvain Sundström from Switzerland with the border collie Penny.
Time to beat 38:20. It's a good split, but he has to keep it up to make the time.
Almost got into the wrong tunnel entrance there.
Yeah, it cost them a little bit of time. Let's see if they can make it anyway. Oh, what a good dog walk.
What a lot of steps on that dog walk.
Yeah, and 37:39.
Oh,
that's
my God.
New lead. That's a new lead and a lot of pressure on the last couple of dogs.
I'm going to get a heartache after these finals. Up next, number 8 from yesterday, Radovan Liska from Czech Republic with the border collie Ori. The time to beat, 37:39.
But Max Spins is in the lead here with Bex on total time of 71:91. So wrong information from us, I'm sorry. See what they can do here. 37:39 is the time to beat. It's a good dog walk. Now they have to run. No. 37:99.
Number 7 from yesterday. Olena Bulova from Ukraine with the border collie Fora.
And the time to beat is 37:39, and Stanislav and... Max Spins is still in the lead.
Oh, five falls on the long jump. I can see they're counting and counting and counting downstairs just to see if the results is good. Because we had time to beat, and he didn't beat a time, but it's in the lead. No, here, it changed now. Sippy and Stanislav is still in the lead. Second, Lisa and Jack, and third, Max and Bex. Yes. No, still in the lead, Lisa and Jack. These results, Liz. From Czech Republic, sixth from yesterday, Teresa Kralova and the border collie Say.
And the time to beat for these two are 38:20, so now we are a little bit up in the time again. Oh, not with that turn, I don't think you will be able to do that. As said, you have to ace this course to take the lead. You have to earn your gold. That's a nice weave.
It's all quiet in here.
Nice round. Let's see the dog walk.
Running.
Yes, nice dog walk.
So beautiful.
And they are through at 37:86. And they had to beat the time 37:77 during this, according to this one, I think. No.
I will not say anything about the results because it's kind of upside down right now.
But I think it's the correct ones. They're just a little bit late in the update here.
We have number 4 from yesterday, Dave Munnings from Great Britain with the border collie Fame.
And you have to beat the time 37:98.
Uh-oh, almost tripped there.
Right now in the lead should be Sylvain and Penny from Switzerland.
Yeah. Uh-oh, five faults on the dog walk, and...
Now England, Great Britain are really cheering here. We're into the last four.
Yeah, and this is Dave Munnings from Great Britain with Border Collie fame. We just saw Jeremiah Simpson from Germany with Border Collie peach. Now we're in top four, Dave Munnings and fame.
Really nice A-frame. This is a fast dog. Nice over seven, up eight and nine and ten. It's a good split, but they have to keep this up.
I can see the Great Britons are standing and almost like jumping.
Yeah.
We have Dan Shaw standing and holding on
their other teammates. Oh, it's a good running. Come on. And they are making the time. 37-61. They're in the lead if we get this correctly here. Yes, they went into the lead. Dave Munnings and fame. Zero fault, 71-41.
Oh, my
and
God.
And they are putting a lot of pressure on this couple here.
Yeah, we are at top three. Third from yesterday, Anne Lenz from Germany and the Border Collie, Itsy Bitsy.
And they are really fast.
Yeah, we only have fast dogs left, so...
Yeah. And time to beat is 37-65.
Oh, good A-frame. 37-65. Do we have a split time?
It's up there, but they have to give it a good run to keep up.
Nice turn.
A little bit slow, though, in the run.
Pick the dog up.
Now you have to run.
Oh, she's ice cold.
Come on.
Yeah,
oh,
it's a hit.
Oh, what a hit it is.
37-65.
And
yes!
They're making it. 36-97. God, they're putting pressure on Jessica and Nicola. God, what a time.
Almost
under 37.
Almost a second under the time to beat. Ho, ho, ho. This is getting hot. Second from yesterday, Jessica Patterson from Canada with the Border Collie Lux. And I'm standing up. The time to beat is 37-21. 37-21. 37-21. Up on...
That's a drop bar. And Len still in the lead.
Yeah, Lenz and Itsy Bitsy from Germany still in the lead. Second place, David Munnings and Fame from Great Britain. And on third place so far, Sylvan and Penny from Switzerland.
And this means, since we only have one dog left, that Dave Munnings and Anna Lenz will get their medals today. The question is just which medal they will get.
Yeah, everything's up to Italy, Nicola and Ira.
Look at this
running!
Ah, it was a hit. And they're over, and they're through. Five faults, 38-53.
Last
look, what a good time, and Lenz got 36-97. That's incredible.
Last dog of the year.
Yeah.
We have from Italy, Nicola Giraudi and the Border Collie Era. And what are they going to do?
The time to beat, 37-40.
37-40.
But we have a time under 37, so it's doable. Come on.
Down the frame, over that jump and over the long jump.
Yes, and over
back
there.
Up. Nine. Up on the seesaw,
nice
all the way down.
Yes,
yes.
And it's a... Oh, God, that split. It's 15-44. It's the first under 16.
It's going so fast.
God, what a split. Come on, come on. Keep it up.
Into the tunnel.
Keep it up.
Back up. Around. All the way over. Over.
Come on, come
over,
on. Come
all
on,
the way down. Come on. Yes,
yes.
It's a hit.
Now
it's
you have
hit.
To run. Come on, Nicola.
Oh, 37-40. Oh, my God.
36-27. God, what a time.
Oh,
God,
my God.
What a time. He takes the win. Both the championship and of this run today. It's 36-27. I didn't think we would get any time under 37. We have two. So we have Nicola Giraudi and Ira for the win. Anne Lenz and Itsy Bitsy for silver. And Dave Munnings and Fame for bronze.
Oh, my God. He wins this with a whole second!
Yeah, Nicola has the total time of 69.6 and Anne Lenz 70.73 and Dave Manning's 71.41. This, what a race, what a competition.
We can see Eira here.
Oh, and they had their split was almost half a second early next compared to the next one. So yeah, this was a good round.
It's so awesome to see. Keeping up the first place like this. And here's the results. As we can see, Nicola and Eira in first place, 69.60. And Anne Lenz and Itsy Bitsy on second place, 70.73. You look there, it's over a second between those. And then it's one more. And Dave Mannings and Fame on third place, 71.41.
And here you get 11 to 20. It's still double zeros. So it's a many, many good rounds today. Many good dogs, many good handlers. What runs we have been seeing. And there they're playing with Eira. She just, oh, that was fun. Can we do some more? Look at this. God, what a round. And the media is playing with Eira. And there we can see some Italian supporters. And many hugs. There we have hugs from Dave Mannings, who got third. And Eira is just playing tag. She just, come on, let's play. This was fun. And here comes the prizes, and this will be the prize ceremony of this class. It was the same, Nicola Giraudi won this class as well. And second, we have Anne Lenz with Itsy Bitsy even in this run. And then on third, Stanislav Korochkin with Sippy, who made the lap of his life, I think. It was so beautiful. And that dog, I can't believe how he can handle her. And she just, okay, I know what to do, and does it by her own.
Yeah, and even though your home country didn't take a medal this year, it's so amazing to just look at this amazing agility and these amazing dog and handlers, and also these amazing courses.
This is so amazing. And now we will see the prize ceremony of this lap and later during the official ending of this ceremony, we will have the prize ceremony for the totals.
We're going to watch the winning round for the agility class and the world championship. Here we go, Nicola and Eira.
Nice and tight. Nice and tight again. Look at this dog. It's just, I can't really explain it. It just turns in the air, and then when it's on the ground, it just beats its paws and gets such a speed.
A little big turn there, before and after the jump, but even though this time, and a big turn there also, and almost a stop at the dog walk.
She slows down, and anyway, she gets this time. That's a dog I can't really explain. It's just, what a dog.
I get goosebumps all over again just by seeing the dog crossing the finish line. And here you can see the way up on the seesaw. So nice seesaw. And what a dog.
Yeah, this is so beautiful. Look at that weave. Up and around. And you can see as soon as she lands, it's full speed. It's not landing and getting up to full speed. It's just landing full speed. It's amazing.
This dog didn't accelerate any time. And look at
her. No, she just runs.
She just run and run.
She doesn't look that big either. So
Yeah, it's a great dog.
We're going to give you the sound of the arena. My name is Sophie Laurier, and my friend here, Emma Svärd. We would really like to thank you guys for watching and listening to us all week.
It's been so fun to talk to you guys. Hope you have had as much fun as we have.
Yeah, and as much tears and nerves.
And screaming.
And goosebumps.
Yeah.
Next year, we will see you in Finland.
Yeah.
We're going to do the prize ceremony for this race. Then we're going to do the prize ceremony for the world champions. And then we're going to have the...
The ending ceremony will be a part of the Great Championship prize. The prize ceremony. So everything of that will be made in the ending ceremony. And we will, of course, show you that. But then it will be the sound of the arena. So we will not talk to you there. But you will get exactly what they're saying in the mics down on the arena during that time. So have a nice evening while watching the ending ceremony. And have a nice week. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
From us. Bye.
We have a result, and this is the result for this class. So this is not the combined result. This is for this class. Please let me introduce to you a winner of this class. His name is Nicola Guardi from Italy with Aira. Nicola! I have vision, oh, I believe. In second place, from Germany, Anna Lenz with Itsy Bitsy. Here you go. Stand up, stand up. Congratulations, Anna Lenz with Itsy Bitsy. On third place, we have from Russia, Stanislav with Sippy. Here he comes with Sippy. And Nicola, the winner. Here we go. It's getting close. Anna Lenz in second. And Stanislav Poroshchin with Sippy. Congratulations. Oh, I have vision. Can't you see? I'm on the move. Make way for me. Stand up for the champions, for the champions. Stand up, stand up, stand up for the champions, for the champions.
In third place, from Russia, Stanislav Kurukin with Sippy. second place. From Germany, Anne Lenz with Itsy Bitsy. And I have the results for the world champion in large 2018, and we will have a lap of honor for them. The world champion in large 2018 from Italy, Nicola Ghiraldi with Ada.
Champions, for the champions, stand up.
In second place, stand from up. Germany, Anne Lenz and Itsy Bitsy.
For the champions,
steht auf, für die champions.
In third place,
champions.
From Great Britain, Dave Munnings and Faith.
Steht auf, steht auf, für die champions, steht auf.
Just who wants it most. It's just life, that's how it is. If we have our strengths and weaknesses. Oh, I have vision, can't you see?
I don't have any energy left.
We understand that when we thought you couldn't go any faster on that course, you just pushed the time. It's amazing.
I am amazed, actually.
Give it up one more time for Nicola and Ada. Now, stay in your seats because we will have the prize giving ceremony for the total results, so all our world champions, and we will also have the closing ceremony, so stay where you are.